What's the difference between an average wedding and a G7 wedding?
It ain't coming out.
Let's find out. So by now I've already done all my preliminary light checks, I've double checked the settings on the camera, and just waiting for the ceremony to get started. Although similar, no two weddings are alike. In this situation, the groom chose not to enter with the officiant, but instead chose to enter in through one of the other doors of the chapel. This was a very small and intimate wedding, which had a very small wedding party. It made my job a lot easier. Nevertheless, all weddings deserve the same attention to detail. As the bride approaches the stairwell, you notice a very large and unshaded window off to her left. Logistically, this could be a nightmare for most photographers, depending upon where the sun is that day. This is why my clients hired a professional photographer to deal with situations like this. Another important detail to capture is the groom's first look at his bride when she comes into view. This is a detail that your wedding couples will be glad that you captured as they review the gorgeous lady. Using a 70-200 lens allows me to step back and not be too intrusive. You want to capture the wedding organically. You don't want to become the center of attention. I've always felt that my job is to be seen, but not seen. It's not my day, it's the bride and groom. Another thing you want to capture is the handoff, the shaking of the hand as the groom receives his bride. One thing I'm a stickler about is getting to my locations early. This way you can map out the floor plan and easily move throughout the chapel or the sanctuary depending upon where you are. That way you don't have to worry about tripping over chairs or other obstacles which may be in your way.
How wonderful and such a special love flows between two people.
marriage is the very basis of all human society. The world has this idea that marriage is simply a legal contract. It is a legal contract, but at the same time, it's a spiritual contract. Marriage is a sacred institution. It's ordained by God, regulated by His commandments, and blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ. Marriage should be held in high honor and esteem among all men and women. The heart of any marriage is the promise and commitment which the husband and wife make to each other. Daryl and Corinne stand before us today.
Another thing you want to make sure you do is capture multiple angles of your couple as they stand there while the ceremony is being carried out.
To be your wife and your friend for life. Will you commit yourself to her happiness? Will you promise
I've heard of some situations where the officiant or the pastor will only allow you to capture the ceremony from the back of the church or the venue that you may be in. If that's the way things have to be and your couple understands it, then so be it.
Be your husband and your friend for life. Will you commit yourself to his happiness?
It's always a good thing to make sure you kept your multiple shots, because you never know when someone may blink or look away.
And to be truly loyal to him, so long as you both show it.
Having shot at this venue many times before, I'm familiar with all the different back ways and pathways I can take to aid me in capturing the shots that I need. This way, I'm not really inhibited by other would-be photographers with cell phones or videographers.
I promise to remain true to you in all circumstances of life.
One thing that I make sure that my clients understand, and I tell them all the time, my job, my number one job, is to make your day as less stressful as possible when it comes to the subject of photography. Again, make sure that I capture the details. That's another advantage to shooting such a small wedding party. I don't have to worry about changing lenses. I'm able to capture the couple, the officiant, and the best man and the maid of honor if there happens to be one. And then at the same time, if I want to get close enough to capture a ring shot, I'm able to do that also without worrying about switching lenses and missing a possible shot.
I want you to say this to him. With this ring, I thee wed. It is a token of my love and faithfulness.
A token of my love and faithfulness.
I believe with all my heart that this is forever.
It ain't coming off.
The ring is in the shape of a circle without beginning or end.
On more than one occasion, I've had individuals tell me, why am I investing all this money in cameras when I could simply capture the same thing with an iPhone or an Android? Yeah, right. Good luck capturing the dynamic range that we capture as photographers. When I say dynamic range, I'm talking about things like capturing the bride, the groom, and the atmosphere of the room, and at the same time being able to pull in the background of the outside environment. Or in this case, capture the bride and the groom as they stepped up to do the candle ceremony and still being able to capture the flame while it's burning from the candles.
1 Corinthians 13:3. Love is patient, love is kind, and it's not jealous. Love does not brag, but it's not arrogant, it does not act unbecoming. It does not seek its own, it's not provoked, it does not take into account a wrong suffering. It does not rejoice in unrighteousness, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears up under anything and everything that comes, is ready to believe the best about every person, hopes under all circumstances.
During the course of the wedding day, I may capture anywhere from 200 to sometimes as many as 700 images per day. Although all images are important, the most important image of the whole day is the first kiss of the bride and groom as a married couple. This is something you don't get a chance to do over. This is something that never gets old. Genuine love and happiness. Another thing that I make sure that I capture is the signing of the licenses by the bride and groom. Again, this is something they may want the details of later.
All right, so Corinne, on the bottom right, very bottom line, you're going to print first, middle, new last name. And then second from bottom, you're going to sign first, new last name. And then Daryl on the bottom left, very bottom print, second from bottom sign.
After the signing of the licenses, I notify the couple that I will be waiting for them in the chapel so that we can get started with their aftershots. At this point, we enter what I call phase 2 of the wedding day.